audio article by the Common Constitutionalist entitled, "The Left Likes Competition." Wait, no they don't. Remember when Obama said part of the problem with Obamacare in some areas is that there is literally no competition? Entire swaths of states had but one insurance carrier, which translated to zero competition. Remember that? He said that a lack of competition is a bad thing. It affords the one provider an opportunity to take advantage of customers, and of course, service suffers as well. Obamacare resulted in the creation of 23 co-ops across the nation, wrote Reason.com in July of 2016. Some of which served hundreds of thousands of customers. As of this month, however, only 10 remained fully operational. The other 13 have either shut down or announced they plan to do so by the end of the year. That same month, July 2016, in a Journal of the American Medical Association, JAMA article, Obama proposed creating a government-run insurance plan, or public option, that would exist alongside private health insurance, at least in the most rural areas where competition is sparse or non-existent. He wrote that, quote, "Congress should revisit a public plan to compete alongside private insurers in areas of the country where competition is limited," unquote. Some on the right said, there, you see, he is admitting Obamacare isn't working. They were and still are wrong, my friends. Obamacare has always worked as it was intended. It was always structured in a way which caused private insurers to fail, forcing the feds to step in and save the day with the only plan that would rescue the failing industry, a single-payer, VA-type, socialized, government-run health system. Just as predictably, those on the left praised the Obama initiative. These private companies need a little side-by-side competition to keep them honest. And they are correct. Nothing fosters success and customer satisfaction like competition. I will leave alone the fact that no company can ever compete with the federal government. So I find it ironic that the mainstream media just last week began hammering Trump on his plans to privatize the VA. Yet they can't even get this right. They've even dragged back out the fossil Bernie Sanders to make the case. Sanders says that, quote, "Privatizing the VA would be an insult to the more than 22 million vets who risk their lives to defend our country, and it would significantly lower the quality of health care that they receive," unquote. And he even dragged the Koch brothers into the argument. These people are obsessed with the Koch brothers. Now, putting aside the outward absurdity of Sanders' statements, he and other leftists have it wrong. Trump doesn't wish to scrap the VA entirely. His plan is to inject some competition into the VA system so that patients, you know, our heroic men and women in uniform, may have a choice of care, not simply locked into the failed and corrupt government system. In fact, Trump issued his 10-point plan to fix the VA in July, the same month Obama suggested injecting competition into the failing private market, which was hailed as genius. The last item on the 10-point plan was, quote, "Mr. Trump will ensure every veteran has the choice to seek care at the VA or at a private service provider of their choice. Under the Trump administration, no veteran will die waiting for service. These days are over starting January 2017, unquote. It seems to me that Trump's plan seeks to do exactly what Obama proposed, inject a little competition. Yet the left hates one and loves the other. That's politics for you. Thanks for listening.